The purpose of this video is to show you what happens with the addition method when you are solving a system that has either infinite number of solutions or no solution. So we're going to look at the system on the left first, the negative 6x plus 16y equals 8, and the negative 3x plus 8y equals 4. We're using addition method, so we're going to choose a variable that we can swap the coefficients on. We're going to go ahead and choose the x's because those numbers are smaller. So we're going to throw a set of parentheses around both equations, highlight the coefficients on the x terms, and then we're just going to swap those coefficients. We're not worried about positives or negatives right now. We're just worried about swapping the coefficients. Then take a look at your two x terms. Notice they have the same sign. When that happens, one of your outside numbers needs to have a negative added to it. So we've swapped it, we've added a negative, and now we're going to distribute. So the negative 3 multiplied by the entire first line gives you positive 18x minus 48y equals negative 24. And then the positive 6 multiplied by the entire second line gives you negative 18x plus 48y equals positive 24. Now the addition method means we're going to add these two lines together now that we've created some opposites in our x positions. Notice that the x's do cancel out just as we intended, but in this case the y's also cancel out, leaving us with nothing on that left hand side. You're going to fill that space with 0 as placeholder. On the right hand side, your 24's, negative 24 and positive 24 also cancel. So that gives us a final expression of 0 equals 0, which is true. Because this is true, this is infinitely many solutions. When that happens, it means that the lines are the exact same line and they're lying right on top of one another. Let's look at the example on the right-hand side of the screen now. The negative 7x minus 14y equals 21, and 3x plus 6y equals negative 12. Let's pick a variable. This time we're going to do x's again, just because the numbers are slightly smaller. Put your parentheses on and highlight those values and swap them. Now look at your x terms, and it looks like it's different signs because the top line has a negative x and the bottom line has a positive x. When this happens, you're just going to use the values as they are. You're not going to add a negative at this point. So now you can distribute. The top line, when you multiply it by 3, becomes negative 21x minus 42y equals 63. And the bottom line multiplied by 7, positive 21x plus 42y equals negative 84. In this case, we're going to add the lines together again because we are using addition method. The x's do cancel out as we intended. The y's also cancel out, leaving us with nothing on the left-hand side. But this time, the numbers on the right-hand side don't cancel. They actually add together to give you a negative 21. When this happens, 0 obviously is not equal to negative 21, so that's a false statement, and that's when you have no solution. These would be parallel lines and never touching. So reviewing on the left-hand side of the screen, when you added those two equations together, everything canceled and it became a true statement. And on the right-hand side of the screen, when you added everything together, the left-hand side with all the variables canceled, but there was still a constant left over. In that case, it's false and no solution.